Hi, this is Becky Weiss with the Howard County Library System, and today we're going to take a look at creating a Google account. So we're going to start by opening up a browser window. Now this is just going to be whatever program that you use to access the internet. So today I'm using Safari, but you could be using another option like Google Chrome, Firefox, or Internet Explorer. Any program will work. What you're going to do first is look at the top of your screen and find your address bar. This is universally located no matter what browser you're using. It should be at the top of your screen, so you can see mine here. And we're going to click and type google.com and then hit enter on our keyboard. So you should see the Google homepage just like my screen here. And you want to find the sign in button and click on that. So if we had an existing Google account, this would be the page that we use to sign in. We would put our email here and then hit next to type in our password. But because we are creating an account, we're going to go over to the left here and click create account. And we're going to choose for myself. And then we're going to be redirected to another page that's asking for a little more information. So I'll start with my name. And my last name. And then when you click in the username field, you'll see that it fills in a response for you. So why does it do this? Well, a username has to be unique to you. That means no one else that has a Google account can have the same username as you. And because of the popularity of Google, that can be a little challenging. So Google kind of helps you out by using information like your first and last name to create a username for you. But you don't have to keep the auto-generated username. So I'm going to go in here, double-click on this, hit backspace. And I'm going to type in just my first and last name. When I click down in the password field, you can see I get an error that the username is already taken. So someone else using Google already has the username Becky Weiss. So you can try as many different usernames as you want until you get one that has not been taken and that you like and can remember. But just to move this along, I am going to come down here to the available usernames that Google suggests and just click the first one. All right, next I'm going to put in a password. You can see below the field that the password must use at least 8 characters and you have to include letters, numbers, and symbols. Symbols are things like exclamation points, at symbols, periods, question marks, things like that. So I'm also going to confirm the password, just typing the same password in again. And then take a moment right now, grab a piece of paper, or if there is a place that you keep passwords for other accounts, you should definitely write down your username and password. Google can be very challenging to regain access to your account if you've forgotten your username or password. So definitely write it down before you move on to the next page. So after that, we're going to click next. And then you'll come to another page asking for a phone number and a recovery email address. So on my view here, both the phone number and the recovery email are optional, but this may not be the case for you. Depending on a number of different factors, one being if you have multiple Google accounts, it may be required that you put in a phone number. So that's just going to be your personal decision. If you feel comfortable sharing your phone number in order to create the account, you can do that. So for me, I'm going to choose to leave the phone number and the recovery email address field blank. The recovery email address is just another email that you have. So not in @gmail.com, but maybe in @yahoo.com or @verizon.net. Just another email account so that if you do lose your username or password, you have an option to retrieve that information through your recovery email address. So next I'm going to come down and just put in some random values for birthday. And for gender, rather not say. And then we can click next. Again, this is just things from your phone number. I'm going to choose to skip that. And then we come to the privacy and usage terms. So take a look at that. If everything looks good to you, you can click I agree. And then we're done. So we come to the Google Home page. We can see here that we're signed in by this little icon with, for me, it's a B, but depending on your first name, it could be a different letter. So that indicates that we are signed in to our Google account. If we were not signed in, that icon would be a sign-in button like we saw at the beginning of the video. So now we're going to take a look at how you will sign into your Google account in the future. So I want you to close all your windows, open up a brand new browser window, and again, we're going to go to google.com. All right, then we're going to come up here to the sign-in button. And we're going to type in that username that we just created. You don't have to include the @gmail.com. You can if you want to, but not necessary. And then when you're done with that, you can hit enter on your keyboard or hit the blue next button. And then type in your password. If you have trouble typing in your password, you can click that show password option. And that way, instead of those little security dots, you will actually see what you're typing. It might be clearer for some people. And then you can click next or hit enter. And then we're signed in. You can see our little letter icon right up here, indicating that we are signed in. And then from here, you can access all of the different tools that Google offers. So right here where it says Gmail, you can click on that and that takes you to your email account. So you can see here, I have a bunch of auto-generated emails from when I created the account. I'm sure you'll have some of those too. And then if you want to sign out of your account, you're going to click your little letter icon and then click sign out. And then that's it. You've created your account and you can sign into it. In the next few videos of this series, we're going to take a look at all of the tools that you can use with your Google account. So I hope to see you for them.